Hello and welcome to my editing room. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer, and I specifically want to talk to you today about editing. How do we get from that photo shoot to the finished image? And a lot of it happens in post-production. So I'm editing on a Microsoft Surface Studio computer right now, which means that I can do this with it and edit directly on the screen because it's a touch screen. And that's really helpful for the type of work that I do because specifically I'm doing a lot of cutting, a lot of really fine detail work. Because I'm a compositor, I often have to take one subject or image and put it on top of another and cut it out and blend it. So that's what we're gonna do today. I've got this image up. It's one of three images actually in a set that I created, and these are some of my most popular best-selling images. So I wanted to go through this particular edit to talk about how we blend somebody into a new backdrop as I did here, how to deal with the clutter and chaos of having lots of things happening in an image and more. So let's go back to the beginning. So far down. And here we have the backdrop. Now this backdrop was shot out of focus. And that's a weird thing to do, right? Because why would you do that? But I knew that I wanted somebody in the foreground who would really stand out against that backdrop. So I added a fog layer in, and this fog layer does something interesting because here you can see where the horizon is, but here you can't, so you're really not sure how far it extends. And I really like taking away that bit of knowledge from the viewer. All right, so here I am in my nightgown. This is actually a bed sheet. I use bed sheets all the time for costumes, and it just makes this really timeless, simple, and often elegant look. So that's what I use. Now, I was not there to begin with, and I had to cut myself out, so I did that with this layer mask, but also with the background eraser tool, which we have talked about before, and that's the tool right underneath the regular eraser tool, background eraser, and this works best when you have a subject that contrasts from their background. So we'll take more of a look at that in just a moment. You can see, I won't skip over that we're changing the color of the bed sheet. I didn't want it to be white, so I made it this sort of rosy yellow color. And I did that by selecting the bed sheet with my lasso tool, feathering it just a little, and then adding in some color. So here we have more hair. I took lots of shots of my hair moving all around. More hair. Lightening that up and more, and the edges of my hair were able to be edited in because of the background eraser tool. It's really, really important to note that. The background eraser tool will just allow you to erase against something, so I would go around the edges of my hair and it naturally separates the background from the foreground. All right, so I'm adding on more little bits of hair, but now we've got all of these butterflies. You see butterfly 1, 2, 3, 4 in their shadows. So let's go ahead and get a bunch on at once. We have previously looked at an image with lots of butterflies on me and their shadows. And so that's what this is, tons of butterflies. And this is the natural thing to do right now. Like, I'm putting them on my body, looks really lovely, but I wanted the flow to go up and out of the frame. And so I added more butterflies up in the air so that the viewer's eye naturally followed a path. I made sure that my hair moved in that same direction. Everything working toward the goal of getting the viewer's eye to start right on my subject's face and then up and out of the frame. That's super important to me because when you're thinking about composition, at least in my country and in many countries, we read from left to right, and so our eye will naturally hit the frame at the left and then move out the right hand side. And I love when my eye hits the subject first. So here we go, several more changes as we're going through. Lots of color, lots of darkening of the image, textures, so many little changes. But it's not until the end, really, that we get something really special, I think. Right now, this image is a bit dull, and we have this effect in the background of two opposing colors. We have a purple and a green. And essentially the way that you would get a purple is by adding a lot of magenta into an image, and the way that you get green is by taking away magenta. And so we have two opposing colors, and they're not my favorite colors. So to have them both competing for attention in this frame, I don't love that. And that's why you'll start to see here with this little change, I'm taking away that green color and adding in something in that purple magenta family. So by keeping this image warm and recognizing it as a warm image, I can continually make small changes to bring about that warmth. You know, it's really easy to stop here and not really be sure about what's causing the distraction for me, like why I don't love this, but really start to get into color theory and think about what colors are you drawn to. You might love it like this, and that's great, and there's no right or wrong, of course, but I don't love it, and so I started to warm this image up quite a bit, add saturation to it, and then took it as far as I could in the final image to create this really cohesive color flow as well. You know, we talk about composition, flow in composition, the way that the eye moves across the frame in a certain way. But what about color? Color can stop us in our tracks or steal our attention. And that is something that can be amazing as a tool or really detrimental. So when you're thinking about composition and color, think about flow and how do you want your viewer to look at your images? So important. You know, we tend to say, well, I create for myself only, but I don't at all. I create half for me, half for you. I want people to look at my work. And so if I want that, I better start thinking about how they're going to view it. I love this image. I think it's a really soft, beautiful image for me. And because, you know, I make a lot of hard, weird things. And so this one's really nice and soft, and I'm really glad that we could go over how it was made, how it was built, and some of the decisions that went into it. I hope that you have a wonderful week creating. I hope this was helpful for you. Let me know if it was, and I can't wait to see you next. Bye.